weather and location. You can't drive there, and in the wintertime you can't walk there either. The Plate Boundary Observatory maintains continuously operating GPS systems at Mount St. Helens, and it also includes tilt meters as well as borehole instruments, including borehole strain meters and borehole seismometers. All of the instruments at Mount St. Helens allow us to be able to measure how the surface of the volcano is changing its shape, or also detect small earthquakes that are occurring within the interior of the volcano. And from this information that we gain at the surface, we can make some inferences about what's going on at depth inside the volcano. The single biggest user of the data from Mount St. Helens is the Cascades Volcano Observatory.
We can't really afford to just have data from 2 or 3 months of the year when the weather's nice. We have to have it year round.
The snow can, if it gets very thick, can be very heavy, and it can actually break the monuments, it can break the radomes that cover the antennas, it can break the huts, it can break the solar panels. We've learned how to use certain types of enclosures we've learned how to make sure we can get them tightly coupled to the ground with guy wires and things like that so they don't get affected by wind. We've learned how to put more solar panels, more batteries, and wire the batteries in a way so that the power is, we don't have as much loss of the power when we're not getting solar charging. I think the most important thing we've learned in general is how to operate efficiently and safely in these difficult environments. Our engineering staff have been able to effectively work under very, very difficult conditions, building and maintaining these stations, both on Mount St. Helens and other equally difficult locations, for example, in the Aleutians, without any kind of incident. Mount St. Helens is an excellent example of the way the Earthscope program was originally designed. At Mount St. Helens, we've worked very, very closely with the scientists at the Cascade Volcano Observatory in order to make sure that both the scientific community as well as the USGS scientists and technicians can get the data that they need to serve their particular missions.